Okay, in the previous video, we introduced the concept of conservation laws, and we got started with the conservation of mass. And the idea is that we want to be able to describe the inflow and outflow and accumulation of some quantity inside a system. So in this case, we're talking about mass. So we talked about how to describe inflow and outflow of mass through some surface that has some area dA and it's oriented with some normal vector n. So here we're going to pick up where we left off and apply these definitions and this language that we came up with to actually write a conservation law. So the starting point, I'm going to draw here a coordinate system. Here it's a Cartesian coordinate system with axes x, y, and z. And so in this coordinate system I can locate a point at some position x, y, and z, and at this point I'm going to say there's some velocity vector v. So there's a flow with some velocity that is described also with x, y, and z components. So now I'm going to draw around this point differential cube with width with sides of length delta x, delta y, and delta z. So these are very small differential size distances in the x, y, and z direction. And this point is in the center of the cube. So I've drawn this cube with the center at point x, y, z. Okay, so what do we know? We know the following. So we can express the velocity. We know that's a vector quantity, so I'm going to write that out in Cartesian coordinates. So I can express this in terms of three components in the x, y, and z directions. So u, v, and w are the x, y, and z components of the velocity, and I, j, and k are unit vectors in the x, y, and z direction. Then, if you remember from last time, we can express the mass flux. That's an expression of the mass per unit time per unit area, and we showed that we can express that mass flux through a surface as rho v dot n, where rho is the density, v is the velocity, and n is a unit normal, is a normal vector, normal to the surface that we're talking about. So that helps us locate the surface and its orientation. Okay, so let's look at one of the faces of this cube. So this x face, I can determine its normal vector. So this face has an outward pointing normal in the plus x direction, right? So n is, the components of n would be 1i, 0j, plus 0k, right? There's no components in the y or z direction. So the unit normal vector corresponding to this surface is just I. And similarly, I can then write v dot n. So it's the dot product of the velocity times the normal vector to the surface. So I have my three components, u, v, and w. So I multiply the x component of v times the x component of n, u times 1, plus the y component of v times the y component of n, v times 0, plus the z component of v times the z component of n, w times 0. And so the normal vector doesn't have any components in the y and z direction, so v dot n is just u. And remember that the dot product between two vectors returns a scalar, is an operation that returns a scalar quantity. Okay, so I'm going to talk about these two faces here, a and b, and both of these have normal vectors that are parallel to the x direction. So first I'm going to look at face a and ask, you know, what is the mass flux coming in through face a? And so I can write that as follows. Let me write it down and then I'll explain it here. Okay, so I know that the mass flux is rho v dot n. But for these faces that have a unit normal vector in the x direction, then v dot n is just u, right? So rho v dot n is rho u. Okay, so but rho u, remember this refers to the quantity at the center. Right, at the point that I'm talking about is at the center of this differential cube. And I'm asking about what's happening at these faces that are some distance away from the center. So I need to take the value at the center and then apply a little correction factor to account for how this quantity may change from the center to the surface of this of face A. So the value at the center plus the partial derivative of rho u with respect to x. So this is the rate of change of this quantity in the x direction times the distance in the x direction from the center to face A. And so since I've put this in the center, then and this is a width delta x, so the distance from the center to face A is half the length of this face, or delta x over 2, and I'm going in the negative x direction. Okay, so this is a value at the center, and then I map the quantity rho u to that face. So I take the rate of change of that quantity with distance in that direction, in the x direction, times the distance from the center to face A, minus delta x over 2. Okay, then let's check the units also, right? So, right, we have mass per time per area. And again, this is at the center. And this quantity represents the change in the quantity rho u from the center out to face A. Okay, so similarly, we can apply the same kind of analysis at face B. We can get the mass flux out of the x face at B. So again, this has the normal vector is also in the x direction, so we have rho u, and then we map the quantity out to face B. So we have the rate of change of rho u with x, partial of rho u with respect to x, times the distance in x from the center to face B. And so this distance is plus delta x over 2. Okay, so let me redraw on the next slide sort of the basic setup here. We have our point x, y, z, and there's a velocity vector associated with that point, and then we draw a differential cube around it of with sides delta x, delta y, and delta z. And we talked about the inflow into the left-hand face of rho u plus partial of rho u with respect to x times minus delta x over 2, and then the outflow from the right-hand face as rho u, the value of the center, plus the partial of rho u with respect to x times delta x over 2. Okay, so now let's apply that to the top and bottom faces of this cube. So the mass flow in at the bottom face is rho v, so remember rho v dot n. So v dot n, the normal vector is in the y direction. So we have our rho times the v component times the y component of the velocity, which is v. So we have rho v times plus the rate of change of the quantity rho v with respect to y times the distance from the center to this bottom face, which is minus delta y over 2. And similarly, the mass flow out at the top face, rho v plus the rate of change of rho v with respect to y times the distance from the center to the top face, which is delta y over 2. Okay, so I think you can see sort of how we can express the mass flow through these faces. So now let's try to apply this in the context of a conservation law. So remember what we had is in the context of mass is the quantity that we're interested in, so the accumulation of mass inside this this cubic space is equal to the inflow minus the outflow. So we can write that down here. So the accumulation, the partial derivative with respect to time of the mass, right, the time rate of change of mass, so this is just the density mass per unit volume times the volume of this cube, which is delta x, delta y, delta z, so it's just the volume. And so that's equal to the inflow minus the outflow. And so we have expressed this in terms of all these components. So let's just write down what we have here. So this is for the x component, right? So the mass flow in from the left-hand face times the area of that face, delta y, delta z, minus the flow out of the right-hand face times its area, delta y, delta z. Then we come to the faces with a normal in the y direction. So the inflow, rho v plus partial of rho e with respect to y times minus delta y over 2 times the area of this face, delta x, delta z, minus rho v plus the partial derivative of rho v with respect to y times delta y over 2 times the area of the face, which is delta x times delta z. And again, similarly, we can do the same thing on the z faces. I haven't shown it here because this drawing is going to get really crowded if I do it, but you can see the pattern. You know, we have rho w, the inflow, plus partial of rho w with respect to z times the distance to the, I guess, the face that's farthest away from us. So minus delta z over 2 times the area of that face, which is delta x times delta y, minus rho w plus partial of rho w with respect to z times the distance to the, from the center to the front face, delta z over 2 times the area delta x delta y.